Stephen Newing was 11 years old when he disappeared near his home in Norfolk on the 2nd of September 1969. Stephen lived with his mother and three younger siblings on Lee Warner Avenue in Fakenham, Norfolk. Stephen had left his home to visit a friend, and when he didn't arrive home by 10 p.m, his mother Jean called the police. There was a police search of the local area, but they found nothing linking to Stephen. After he was reported missing, members of the public reported they had seen a boy matching Stephen's description in Sutton Bridge, Lincolnshire, and later in Suffolk. However, the police were unable to verify either sighting. A friend apparently saw Stephen on the night of his disappearance, walking alone along near the junction of the A149, close to Hindingham turnoff. The police theorised that Stephen may have run away, although the police say there was no reason for this and he may have fallen down a well. Stephen's home was searched twice by the police to ensure he was not hiding, and police were confident his family were not responsible for his disappearance. A circus worker who was in the area at the time of Stephen's disappearance was interviewed as a potential abductor, and all inquiries from the time of the initial investigation has long since been closed. In 2009, detectives appealed for information on the 40th anniversary of his disappearance. It was reported that the police had the feeling Stephen had been abducted, but there was no real evidence to prove it. Detective Inspector Andy Guy, who leads Norfolk's police cold case team, said the investigation could be solved if somebody with a guilty conscience finally came clean. He said, "People keep secrets, and sometimes they keep secrets for somebody else. There is someone out there who knows something about what happened to Stephen. There is somebody out there who is either involved or who suspects they know who was involved. They might have felt they were not able to come forward at the time, but after 40 years, feel the need to speak about it. This case is an ongoing inquiry, and anniversaries give us a good opportunity to jog memories." In May 2014, a news article said Stephen's mother, Jean, wanted the police to interview a notorious paedophile named Sidney Cook, as he was working in the time as a fairground worker, known as Hissing Sid. As of the recording of this video, he is still serving life in HMP Wakefield Prison for the killings of the multiple young boys and is 91 years old. He was the leader of a gang of paedophiles who were known as the Dirty Dozen and are believed to have been abducted, drugged, raped and killed up to 9 children. A former intelligence officer of the Norfolk Police, who was not part of the original investigation, is credited with this breakthrough. Chris Clark, who is now retired, specialises in cold cases. He traced Cook to a family-run business who had a fair few miles away from Stephen's home. Chris said, "I believe there is strong circumstantial evidence linking to Cook to the Norfolk area at the time Stephen went missing. We know he worked in travelling fairs, and I have confirmed a family firm he worked for had a fair in a few miles away. There was also one sighting of Stephen with a man, and the age and description matched Cook at the time. I believe the police should question Cook in prison. He holds the key to this mystery." Cook worked for a company that had been a travelling fair in the town of East Durham, in which was 15 miles away from Fakenham on the day of Stephen's disappearance. With the detectives initially thinking Stephen had run away, this may have hampered the inquiry into a possible abduction. However, there is two possible sightings which I mentioned earlier, with the first describing a boy of Stephen's appearance with a bearded man in his 40s, with, like I mentioned before, this man fitted the age and description of Cook at that time. Stephen's mother apparently was shown a police footage of a boy with fairground workers several years after Stephen disappeared, and says she was taken to a fairground to question the staff. According to the news article, Norfolk police said they would not be speaking to Cook about his whereabouts on the day Stephen disappeared, which greatly upset Stephen's mother, Jean. In the 1980s, Cook and his gang would hire rent boys or abduct vulnerable boys off the street for orgies in a flat on Kingsmead Estate in Hackney, East London. His gang members all paid £5 to rape and abuse 14-year-old Jason Swift, who subsequently died and was discovered in a shallow grave. Cook and three of his accomplices, Leslie Bailey, Robert Oliver and Stephen Barrow, were jailed in 1989 for manslaughter. He was named by one of the gang as a killer of seven-year-old Mark Tiddlesley, who vanished in 1984 while visiting a fair near home in Wokingham, Berkshire. Miraculously, he was freed in 1998, but luckily was rearrested the following year and was jailed for life for the repeated abuse of two young brothers in the early 1970s. Police detectives had been investigating claims Cook helped organise sex parties where politicians and other VIPs would abuse children at the time of the newspaper article being published. In 2015, Detective Inspector Andy Guy said, "It's now been 46 years since Stephen disappeared. Despite the passage of so much time, the police will still act on any genuine information they receive to bring a conclusion to Stephen's case. That conclusion will come too late for Stephen's poor mother, who died on the day before the anniversary of his disappearance in 2014. Speaking to the Times in 2013, then aged 77, she said she still thought of his freckled face, mischievous boy every day. At a celebration event to mark the 10th anniversary of the opening of Steve Newing House in Fakenham, which houses and supports vulnerable 16 to 25 year olds, she said, "I think of his cheeky little freckled face and the way he always used to get up to mischief, whether it was falling off his bike, falling out of a tree, or having his teeth knocked out by a football. I still very much want to know what happened to him. At my age, I don't know that I'll ever know the truth, but I feel it's important to me to find out." Police never close their files, and so-called cold cases are regularly reviewed for new lines of inquiry. As of January 2019, there is no further information of Stephen's disappearance or any active inquiries.